President Trump's eldest son suggesting a high-level government conspiracy is underway in Washington, attempting to block his father's agenda. While speaking to young conservative college activists, Don Jr. lashing out at special counsel Robert Mueller's probe.
I'm glad that this is coming out now because it is good, because real people have to see this. You know, my father talked about a rigged system throughout the campaign, and people are, oh, what are you talking about? But it is. And you're seeing it. There is, and there are, people at the highest levels of government that don't want to let America be America. They don't want to let the little guy have a voice.
Those comments come as some of the right are ramping up attacks. Special counsel's investigation, saying it is politically compromised at this point. Joining me now to discuss, Asha Rangappa, former FBI special agent, Michael Allen, former member of the George W. Bush National Security Council, and Samantha Vinograd, who served on President Obama's National Security Council. As we look at this, not let Americans be Americans, that's a question in and of itself. But Michael, the idea for some people is not new, that there would be some conspiracy in the highest levels of government. How does it change things, though, when you have the president's son saying this?
I think it changes it significantly and kind of contributes to the larger denigration of our political dialogue here. I mean, on the one hand, he is at a fundraiser or speaking to rock-ribbed Republicans, and so it's traditional to throw a little red meat out. But I'm not a fan of this, and I think it's sort of part of a larger plan to lay a framework that if Mueller goes and indicts anyone in the White House, that there will have been able to say, hey, see, this was political. Unfortunately, you know, this is what Bill Clinton did to sort of denigrate and trash Ken Starr during that special counsel investigation. I didn't like it then, and I don't really like it now.
We're hearing reaction as well. Michael Hayden on our air earlier today. Here's what he had to say.
That's more than just a little bit scary. That is a barely coded attempt to say America should be governed by the unchecked will of the executive. And those so-called forces pushing back, they also go by the popular name, the rule of law, and the system of checks and balances that have governed us for 2.5 centuries. From the outside looking in, this is a family that is used to getting its way. And when people stop that from happening, they're viewed as enemies rather than, in the American political system, doing their job with competing and co-equal branches of government.
Former Director Hayden, they're saying that these comments undermine the rule of law. He's clearly taking them very seriously. To Michael's point, though, Samantha, it's not the first time that we have heard something like this. We've heard someone try to undermine an investigation. Is the public perception, though, different this time around in this climate?
I think that Donald Trump Jr.'s statements are both inaccurate and dangerous. So the answer to your question is yes. They're inaccurate because they perhaps purposefully misrepresent the majority of U.S. government employees. Both Asha and myself were career civil servants. We served under Republicans. We served under Democrats. We were just there to do our job. His statements are also dangerous because, frankly, they're taking a page right out of Vladimir Putin's playbook. The intelligence community has assessed with high confidence that Russia directed a influence and messaging campaign to sow divisions here at home. And there's bipartisan consensus. This has come up at multiple congressional hearings, that there's an ongoing information warfare campaign against the United States to discredit our democracy, including our rule of law. Something that differentiates the United States from Russia is our fair and transparent legal process. And these kind of statements cast doubt on that, and in doing so, make us a lot less safe.
What is the impact, Asha, on those civil servants, on these intelligence officers who are doing their job on a daily basis?
I think those people just keep their heads down and do their job. And I think that precisely illustrates that they're not going to get involved in politics. But to Sam's point, you know, what makes America great and different is that we are built, our government is built on the principles of accountability, transparency, and respect for the rule of law. And I think it's quite ironic that Don Jr. is speaking about the little man, because he has lived literally one of the most privileged lives of anyone on the planet and has yet never served his country at all, including today. He doesn't have a government job. So he must be very surprised that he might be held to account or to answer questions based on, you know, his own behavior. But all I can say to him is, welcome to America. No one is above the law.
to the point of answering questions. If we shift here for a minute, FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe, of course, being grilled yesterday for a number of hours behind closed doors by the House Intel Committee. It is no secret, I think, how Trey Gowdy feels, raising concerns over these texts with Strzok. But Michael, does Grassley want him out?
It's looking that way increasingly so. I mean, I don't believe the FBI is fundamentally politicized. I really don't. But at a minimum, all of these texts and a lot of these articles out there, they look bad. They have an appearance problem. What worries me the most, especially after we've had the tremendous theft of intelligence assets from a variety of different people, is the continuing campaign to discredit our intelligence community and our law enforcement folks who keep us safe every day. I think that's really, really dangerous. And I think while we need to get to the bottom of certain things, we need to do it with some discretion and not overdo these great institutions that are keeping us safe, especially here over the holidays.
Asha, in terms of that, before this investigation is even close to being over, is the outcome already tainted?
I don't think so at all. Remember that Mueller is going through the criminal process and the justice system. At the end of the day, everything that he collects will be presented to a court of law, an entirely different branch of government. They'll determine whether he's met the right standards to, indict people, convict people, whatever the case may be. So whatever is happening in this political sphere may influence how people feel about that, but there is a check on how Mueller can proceed, and I think the rule of law is going to be what settles the issue at the end of the day.
Rule of law will settle the issue. There will always be someone who has different thoughts on that. Sam, to you, in terms of everything else that's come out, though, these texts between agents, connections to Democrats, how damaging is that? Again, back to this issue of public perception.
I think that we had Rod Rosenstein testify last week and say that there was not impropriety from within the FBI. I feel confident that there are oversight structures within the Federal Bureau of Investigation and the Department of Justice such that if anything is going on, they'll find it and they'll nip it in the bud. The issue that's more concerning to me is the fact that we're all spending so much time listening to members of Congress politicize this discussion, point fingers about impropriety, and instead we're not having lines of questioning on the primary national security issue of Russia interfering in our election and attacking our country. We've had multiple hearings by the Judiciary Committee, by the intelligence community, that have fallen along partisan lines. And we've had very few questions about what Vladimir Putin did and what we're actually going to do about it. We have sanctions that are due to go into effect in January. Okay, let's hope that they occur on schedule. But what else are we going to do to deter another Russian attack?
Well, and to your point, what's happening today as
exactly.
We sit here? Appreciate all of you joining us, Samantha Vinograd, Michael Allen, Asha Rangappa.